Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel Provocative Biofield. I am your Sagarika Babu. This is the 10th part of NEET and AIPMT MCQs. So I have totally uploaded 10 videos in NEET and AIPMT MCQs. In each video I am posting 10 questions. So with this video I am going to complete 100 questions in the NEET and AIPMT MCQs. Okay. The link for the first 9 parts of the video is placed in the description box. You can see those videos through the link. And in this video, I have uploaded the questions mostly based on the topic liver. I recently uploaded the video on liver. I placed that link also in the description box. To answer most of the questions in this video, I request you to see that video first. Okay. Before entering into the video, I request you to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon to get updated when I post a video. Now let's start the 10th set of questions. Question number 91. Hepatopancreatic duct opens into the duodenum and carries dash. So, hepato means liver. Pancreatic denotes pancreas. Okay. So, the duct from the liver is called common bile duct, which carries bile juice. Duct from the pancreas is called pancreatic duct, which carries pancreatic juice. Okay. So this common bile duct and pancreatic duct combines to form the hepatopancreatic duct. So in this duct, it contains the bile juice from the liver and pancreatic juice from the pancreas. So the answer for this question is both bile and pancreatic juice. Okay. Hepatopancreatic duct opens into the duodenum and carries both bile and pancreatic juice. Answer is option C. Question number 92. Liver is the largest gland and is associated with functions. Choose one which is not correct. So among the options, metabolism of carbohydrate, digestion of fat, formation of bile, these three are the functions of liver. But secretion of hormone called gastrin, it is not by liver. Okay, because gastrin hormone, it is secreted by stomach to increase the gastric secretion. Okay, gastrin hormone, it is secreted by stomach to increase the gastric secretion. Okay, so it is not the function of liver. So among the options, the odd one is secretion of hormone called gastrin. Okay, so the answer is option D, which is not the function of liver. Question number 93. Structural and functional units of the liver are, the answer is hepatic lobules. Okay, hepatic lobules is the structural and functional unit of the liver. These hepatic lobules are connected to form small ducts. Small ducts are connected to form large ducts. Okay, so right duct and left duct, that is right duct from the right lobe, left duct from the left lobe, these two ducts are combined to form the common hepatic duct. Okay, so hepatic lobules is the structural and functional unit of the liver. These hepatic lobules are covered by Glycine's capsule. Fine. So the answer is hepatic lobules. Question number 94. Products of digestion enter the capillaries of villi and are transported via dash to the liver. So liver consists of two blood supply. One is hepatic portal vein, another one is hepatic artery. So among these two options, hepatic portal vein is the right answer. Okay. So this hepatic portal vein is a blood vessel that carries blood from the gastrointestinal tract, gallbladder, pancreas and spleen to the liver. Okay, this blood contains nutrients and toxins extracted from the digested contents. Okay, so this blood contains nutrients and toxins that is extracted from the digested contents. Okay, so hepatic portal vein is the right answer. Products of digestion enter the capillaries of villi and are transported via hepatic portal vein to the liver. Okay, what is the function of hepatic artery means? It is a blood vessel that supply oxygenated blood to the liver. Okay, so here the answer is option A, hepatic portal vein. Question number 95. Which component of bile is responsible for the emulsification of fats? Options are bile pigments, bile salts, cholesterol, phospholipid. these four options are the components of bile. Okay, all these four options are the components of bile. Among these four components, the which is responsible for the emulsification of fat means, that is bile salts. What are these bile salts means? They are sodium bicarbonate, sodium taurocholate, sodium glycocholate. Okay, these bile salts help in emulsification of large fat droplets into small globules. Okay, so here the bile component which is responsible for the emulsification of fat is bile salts. Option B, bile salts. Question number 96. Glycine's capsule is a connective tissue sheath around the dash. We already saw this in the previous question itself. Glycine's capsule covers what? Hepatic lobule. Okay. So, hepatic lobule is the structural and functional unit of liver. So, this lobule, it is covered by a connective tissue called Glycine's capsule. Okay. So, here the answer is hepatic lobule. Okay. It is covered by Glycine's capsule. Question number 97. Duct of gallbladder is called. Duct of gallbladder is called cystic duct. Okay. Duct from the right and left lobe is common hepatic duct. Okay. Common hepatic duct means combination of right duct and left duct. Okay. So this common hepatic duct, it combines with the cystic duct of the gallbladder to form common bile duct. This common bile duct is also known as ductus choledochus, which is the first option. Okay. So ductus choledochus is also known as common bile duct. Okay. Common bile duct is the combination of common hepatic duct and cystic duct. Common hepatic duct is the combination of right duct and left duct, which is from the right lobe and left lobe respectively. Okay. So here duct of gallbladder is called cystic duct. The option is D, cystic duct. Question number 98. Duodenum has characteristic Bruner's glands which secrete two hormones called. What is this Bruner's glands means? This Bruner's gland, it secrete a fluid containing mucin. Okay. This mucin, it protects the intestinal walls from the gastric juices. Okay. Because they are acidic contents, right? So to protect the intestinal walls, mucus is essential. That mucus, that is mucin, it is secreted by Bruner's glands of the duodenum. Okay. So this Bruner's gland, it secretes another two hormones called secretin and cholecystokinin. Okay. So here among the options, option A is the right answer, secretin and cholecystokinin. So what is the function of these two hormones means? Secretin increases the alkaline volume of bile as well as pancreatic juices. It also decreases gastric mobility. Okay. Next, cholecystokinin. It causes contraction of the gallbladder and releases bile juice. Okay. So here the answer is secretin and cholecystokinin. Option A. Question number 99. Which one of the following is a fat soluble vitamin and its related deficiency disease? What are the fat soluble vitamins means? Vitamin A, D, E, K. These four are fat soluble vitamins. Then water soluble vitamins. Water soluble vitamins are vitamin B and C. Okay. Now let's see the options. Option A, calciferol. Calciferol is vitamin D. Option B, ascorbic acid. It is vitamin C. Option C, retinol. It is vitamin A. Option D, cobalamin. It is vitamin B12. So we need fat soluble vitamin. So among the option A and C, calciferol is vitamin D, retinol is vitamin A. These two are fat soluble vitamins. B and C are water soluble vitamins. So let's omit the ascorbic acid and cobalamin. Now let's see the related deficiency. Calciferol is pellagra. Actually, pellagra is the deficiency of vitamin B3. Okay. It is not the deficiency disease for vitamin D, that is calciferol. Because calciferol deficiency, it causes rickets in children and osteomalacia in adults. Okay. So here first option is not correct. Let's see the third option. retinol is xerophthalmia. Yes, that is the right answer. Because vitamin A deficiency causes night blindness and drying of eyes. Drying of eyes is also known as xerophthalmia. Okay. So here the right option is C, retinol xerophthalmia. So our last question, question number 100. Which one of the following pairs of food compounds in humans reaches the stomach totally undigested? So if we see the options, first three options contains starch. Starch is a food compound where its digestion starts in the mouth itself. Okay, our saliva contains salivary amylase. Okay, it break down the starch. So starch digestion, it starts in the mouth itself. Okay, so first three options are not correct. Let's see the fourth option, fat and cellulose. Okay, fat digestion and cellulose digestion is it's not starts in the mouth, so it reaches the stomach totally undigested. Okay, fat is digested by lipase enzyme, whereas cellulose, actually human cannot digest cellulose, but it is important in the diet as fiber. Okay, so this fiber assists your digestive system by keeping the food moving through the gut and pushing waste out of the body. So this cellulose, it is a breakdown by cellulase enzyme. Okay, so actually cellulose is cannot be digested in the human. The cellulose only assists by keeping the food moving through the gut and pushing the waste out of the body. Okay, its function is only that. So with that, I completed 100 questions. So with that, I completed 10 parts for the NEET and AIPMT MCQs. I explained all the questions very clearly in all the 10 videos. Okay, I'll upload the 11th part of the video soon. If you are new to my channel, please see the first 9 parts of the video. Link for those videos is placed in the description box. Okay. Don't stop when you are tired. Stop when you are done. Okay. Please keep it in mind and work hard for the better life. Thanks for watching. See you soon.